All right, so let's go ahead and move into Eclipse. What I'd like to do is to continue to use the same project as before, JSP Demo. And what I want to do is move down to the web content directory and create a new file. So we're actually going to create a new file for that HTML form. So I'll just do a right click. I'll say new file. The name of this file, I'll call it student-form.html. And once we're happy with the name, we can go ahead and click the finish button. All right, so let's go ahead and expand the window here. I'll set up my basic HTML tags. And then I'll set up a header for the title of this form. And then we'll just go ahead and set up some body tags here real quick. And then we can start building our form. So here I'll say form action equals studentresponse.jsp. So that's the JSP file we're going to send the data to. We haven't created the file yet. We'll create it next, but that's the actual file that we'll send the data to. Now I need to simply go through and create some form fields. So I'll set up the form field for first name. So the input type is text, and the name is equal to first name. And again, that's the exact same name we're going to use on the server side in our JSP when we read the form data. Just set up some line breaks here. And now I'll do a similar thing here for last name. So input type equals text, name equals last name. I'll just do a quick copy paste here on the line breaks. And then finally, to wrap it all up, I'll set up my submit button. So I'll say input type equals submit, and then value equals submit. So the value of submit, that's the actual label that you'll see on the submit button. Oh, and I notice I have a typo on line 17. I spelled the input type submit. I misspelled that one. So let me fix that with an I. Okay, good. Now we're good to go. Okay, so this is the HTML form. It has the first name, last name, and the submit button. Okay, so now let's go ahead and create the JSP page that'll process this. So our student response JSP. So new file. And I'll call it studentresponse.jsp. That's the same name that I referred to in the HTML form. So studentresponse.jsp. And once you're happy with this name, you can go ahead and click the finish button. Okay, great. So let's go ahead and set up our basic tags again and set up our student confirmation. And then take care of the body. All right, so now this is where we need to start reading some of the form data. So first off, I'll say the student is confirmed. And then I want to display their first name and their last name. So I'll make use of that shortcut notation, the $curly brace param.firstname. So it's the same name from the HTML form, and then param.lastname. So basically here we'll have first name space last name for that student once they're registered. All right, so let's go ahead and run the program. So I'll move over to studentform.html. I'll do a right click, and I'll say run as, and I'll choose run on server. Okay, great, so here's our form. We can go ahead and enter some information here. So for the first name, I'll say John, last name of Doe. And once I'm happy with that, I'll hit the submit button. Okay, great. So here's our confirmation page. The student is confirmed, John Doe. So that's the result of us reading the form data that the user entered on their HTML form. So this all looks really good. So good job. So we were successful in reading HTML form data with the JSP page.